Hi. I'm really excited to bring you this new chart today. This chart brings a bunch of other components that we've got on individual charts and brings them all together to offer unbelievable insight into what's happening in your stroke as you're going through it. So let me just show you a couple of things on here now. So this is the swim that I've done just this morning. It's a 50 meter swim, and I know it says it's Ian Thorpe. It's not Ian Thorpe, as you can tell from the time. The pool's called Ian Thorpe. So what we've got here is one lap, 50 meters. And if I just quickly start with the force field, just to show you that, you know, I'm 62% propulsive, which is not bad, actually. It's pretty good. And my downward is smack where it needs to be. I've got a bit too much to the right, but that's okay. But this is my problem. It's my upward force. And I generate that at the back end of my stroke. So I'll show you that when pull becomes push, that's where I tend to generate my upward force from that moment where it becomes push until the hand exits the water. But this end chart is what I want to focus on. So what we've got here is a combination of what you see in the stroke path and hand velocity with the time slider, with the three views, side on, overhead, and head on view, but we'll start off with side on. And this little baby here, this is the critical piece, because this is where we're generating our force. And we're only looking at one stroke. So the beauty about this is it's very easy to read and diagnose within this chart what's going on. And to do that, we want all three vectors switched on. So you can see I've got propulsive, vertical, and lateral switched on. So just a quick recap. The gold right here, as you can see, that's our left hand propulsive. And obviously our objective here is to maximize our propulsion. This red line is our vertical force. So where we're negative down here, we've got downward force. And then where we're generating positive vertical force up here, that's our upward force, which, as you can see, is at the back end of my stroke. And as I mentioned, that's my issue. And then here is my lateral force. And there's a little bit where it's positive at the beginning of the stroke. So this is the hand entry here. So there's a little bit where it's positive, which is an indication that the hand is angled slightly outwards. But then, as I'm pulling, that is now facing inwards. And so I'm generating lateral force inwards. I'm sorry, I should be using my left hand. So it starts off with a little bit of outwards, and then it's coming in. And this is my inward force here. Now, the beauty about this is, and look, let's pick a stroke. Let's go for another one. We won't go for the first one. We'll go for stroke 18. Exactly the same story on the forces. The beauty about this is I can take that slider and I can pull it down. And you'll see that not only does the red dot move, but this red line is moving. And this is showing exactly what forces are being generated in which direction at that point in time where the hand is in that position. And as we slide this down, you'll see that we can go all the way along here and see exactly what's happening. So let's look at a couple of things here. So the start of the stroke, point zero, hand enters the water, glide to here. Now what's really interesting for me is this is the end of my glide, and you can see my hand is about, left hand, sorry, my hand is now going to start to move backwards. It's moving downwards, but it's moving backwards towards my feet. But look at my propulsive force. I don't just start to generate propulsive force until here. So there's this gap in here where I'm generating very little propulsive force. See, it's only just a fraction. And if I move this slider to there, right, so I've effectively gone from here to here, and I'm just now going to start to pick up some propulsion. But you'll see my hand has moved that distance with very little change in propulsion. But what else, and what is that? Well, that is that I've got a really bad catch. I'm not catching the water. My hand is moving, but it's not catching the water, so it's not giving me any propulsion. And this is where I'm starting to catch here. And you can see that where I've got, where I'm generating downward force here, so I've sort of generated a chunk of downward force, and now I'm going to start to generate more downward. And also in here, and this is a really important piece too, is my hand speed. Because, you know, one of the key goals is to have the hand moving slower at the beginning of the stroke, and then as you're getting through the stroke, the hand should accelerate. And you'll see that here with the hand speed. So I'm just going to move it a little bit further. Now, I'm bottoming out at downward force right there. So you can see this is my peak downward force, and where my hand is here, peak downward force. And it's early in the propulsive phase, which is good, because you don't want to be generating downward force when you're peaking your propulsion. So it's quite early here in the propulsive phase. Happy days. And my hand speed has increased from less than 1 meter a second to coming up to close to 2, which is good. And we keep going through here. And now the hand speed is increasing further. We're just about to bottom out. I'll go just a little bit further here. And what we can see here is my point of maximum propulsion. And at my point of maximum propulsion, my hand is pretty much right at the bottom of the arc. Left hand, sorry. Bottom of the arc. Now, interestingly, it's also where we're now starting to generate upward force, right here. But we're maximizing our inward force, our lateral inward. So let's just focus on that lateral inward force too, because what's interesting is when we click on overhead, now we can see the hand path looking from the top. And you can see that this stroke, my hand is moving inwards. And obviously as it's moving inwards and slightly across my body, just slightly, that's where we're generating this inward lateral force here. And so we're peaking there. It's peaking here, and it's about to start pushing directly backwards, which is why here we lose that inward lateral force. But it coincides with my peak propulsive force. So my hand, we'll go back to the side on, is now moving at 2.8 meters a second. So if you remember back here, in fact, we'll come back and just look at that. You know, it's 0.7. Now it's sort of 2.8 meters a second. We're getting to our peak propulsion, and then we can keep moving further through. Here, we're maximum upward force. So this is where I've got that real problem where I am generating upward force. And that upward force is coming at the cost of propulsion. So if I'm able to fix that, if I'm able to get rid of this upward force here, that will be added into my propulsion. If that hand, and I'll do it with my right hand, if that hand could continue to push backwards instead of upwards, then that would just give me an extra propulsive kick right here. But the beauty about this is I can see exactly where this is happening in my hand path. And I can see it not just on the side-on view, but also in the overhead view. And then as we scroll a little bit further on, you'll see that I've got this weird thing going where my hand now moves sideways. So it effectively finishes propulsion here, but it's dragging and moving sideways before it exits the water right there. And so you can see here it's exiting the water. We'll go back to side on. It's exiting the water for the recovery. And looky here. This is where the force goes to zero. Have a look at a right-hand stroke. We can do exactly the same thing on the right-hand stroke. And the other thing I want to point out, and this is really cool, because we've had to up the resolution to do this chart. So we're now showing a significantly higher resolution than we were previously. And you'll see here this pattern. Previously, when it was lower res, because we weren't showing as many increments across the data, this would just be a smooth peak. But now that we've upped the resolution, you can see in here, my right hand, as I'm going through this point here, this is a real wiggle. This is a real wiggle that's happening right at this point, at the point of maximum propulsion, which means, I think it means that I'm not strong enough in my right hand because I am getting this wiggle going on. And that wiggle is indicative for me of that hand just doing some movements like that. And you can see also the effect that it's happening on my lateral force here. And as that hand is wiggling, that lateral direction is slightly changing. I'm sorry, I get really excited with this stuff. I think it's really cool. So as that hand is wiggling up here on the top of the force, you can see it's got that little change happening in the lateral force as well. And you can pinpoint exactly where that's happening. And likewise, here I am peaking with my upward force at this point. It's a real problem I've got, this upward force. And if I could get that upward force out, and I'd be considerably more propulsive. So we can look at that again on the overhead view. We can see what's going on. You can again see here this direction. So right here, as my hand here starts to come in, you can see it's moving in towards my center line. And as it's moving in towards my center line, it's generating this lateral force there, right? It's then still generating lateral force. It's peaking lateral force sort of around here in that area because it's still moving in, and it's probably slightly, just slightly, ever so slightly angled inwards at that point. At the same time, it's getting a little shudder. That shudder is causing this little peaks and troughs at the top of the propulsion. It's also got this shudder on the lateral too. And then we come back to exiting and it slows right down. We'll have a look at hand speed here. It sort of slowed down to 1.6 from 2.8. And then as it exits the water, the hand speed picks up. And you can see it's sort of 4.8 meters a second during the recovery phase here. And then we go again. The one thing also I'll show you is if I just go back to that left again, and you can see I don't have that shudder in the left. I do have this shudder that's going on with the right. And interestingly, it's really shown up on the consistency. When I look at my left-hand consistency, it's not a good stroke, don't get me wrong, but it's reasonably consistent. Whereas my right hand, you can see, has got a fair bit of inconsistency to it. Not to mention both of them have got them coming in, which is also generating that inward lateral force. Anyway, I've gone on speaking too long. It's now over 13 minutes. I'm sorry, but I'm just so excited about this new stroke path and force chart and can't wait for you guys to be able to get it, play with it, look at it and see, you know, what's going on exactly in your stroke at every point within. You can look at every single stroke. You can look at your hand path, your time, your speed, and your force generated in six different vectors, up, down, left, right, forward, back, if you've got the hand drag as well. It's awesome. Enjoy it. Have a play. Thank you.